Study Bassers! In this lesson, we're going to talk about some important distinctions regarding meter and time signatures. So one important distinction to understand is the difference between simple meter and compound meter. So what is simple meter? What is compound meter? Well, pulses in simple meter divide into two, and pulses in compound meter divide into three. Now, what does that mean? Well, it has to do with accents. Meters have patterns of strong beats and weak beats, and musical accents are what create these patterns of strong and weak beats. Now, remember in our last lesson, I pointed out that musical accents are not limited to dynamic accents. That means playing something louder. There are also tonic accents, using a very high or low note, or there are agogic accents, which use a longer duration. So accents and patterns can be created with just about every element of music, and it's often several types of accents that combine together to create the pattern of strong and weak beats in a meter. So, for example, a longer and louder note. Let's compare a simple meter and a compound meter. A measure of 3/4 time and a measure of 6/8 time can both be filled with 6/8 notes, but they're musically different because they have a different pattern of strong and weak beats, which are created by accents. 3/4 time is simple meter, and we can divide each of its pulses into 2/8 notes. So you'll sense a measure of 3/4 as having three strong pulses, which are divided into twos. So listen to the drums accent the three beats. Boom, chuck, chuck, boom, chuck, chuck. And the eighth note bass line is playing root notes through beats one and two, and fifths in beat three. So where that bass note changes helps you sense the pulse of 3 in 3/4 time. It helps you feel the three strong pulses divided into twos. Now let's listen to 6/8 time. 6/8 time is compound meter. We can divide the two strong pulses in 6/8 into 3/8 notes. So listen to how the drums accent beats 1 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the eighth note bass line here changes notes on beats 1 and 4. Again, where the notes change helps establish the feeling of each strong pulse being broken into 3. Notice how the eighth notes are beamed together in 3/4 time to highlight the three pulses divided in two. Now notice how the beams in 6/8 time highlight the two pulses divided into threes. So you might not realize it, but the way beams are written in standard musical notation help you understand the rhythm, meter, and phrasing of the music. So beams are not just a random choice. And you'll find standard music notation gives you a lot of insights like this. It shows you how music works. Now, what would happen if we played the 6/8 bass line with the drums playing in 3/4? It sounds weird, right? It sounds off. It's because of the pattern of strong and weak beats being confused. So you want to hear three strong pulses with the drums, but the bass notes are giving you the sense of two pulses. Now, it's not forbidden to do this. In music, this is an effect known as syncopation. Syncopation occurs when strong accents fall in weak places in the meter. And syncopation draws the listener's attention and creates excitement in music. Some styles and songs use a lot more syncopation than others. Now notice how the beams and note groupings highlight the syncopation in the written music as well. So here's the original 3-4 bass line with the 3-4 drums. It sounds more natural when the three strong pulses are divided in twos. Remember, simple time means the beats are divided in twos. Let's flip it around again and hear the 3-4 bass line in 6-8. Again, it sounds off. The strong pulses and notes don't line up comfortably. It's creating syncopation. And again, you can see the syncopation in the beams of the written notes. So here's the original 6-8 bass line with the 6-8 drums. Compound time is when each strong pulse is divided in threes. So simple meter has a two-ness to each of its pulses, while compound meter has a three-ness to each of its pulses. So in compound meter, the beats have a triplet feel to them. I know you've played in 4-4 time. So what is 4-4 time? Is it simple or is it compound? 4-4 is simple meter. Each of the four pulses divides into twos. The compound version of 4-4 is 12-8, where each of the four pulses is evenly divided into three. Now, you might be thinking, wait, surely you can have more than two notes per pulse or three notes per pulse. What about 16th notes? What about rests and other rhythms? Well, yes, you're right. Simple and compound don't tell you how many notes you can play per pulse. They don't tell you what the rhythms are. They just tell you whether the pulse is evenly divided into a grid of two or three. Then that division of two or three can be further divided in any way you like. So a pulse in simple meter might have a single quarter note, 2/8 notes, an eighth and 2/16, or various rests. So a wide variety of rhythms is possible, but the underlying division of a simple meter pulse is always two. A pulse in compound meter has an underlying division of three, but again, that pulse can contain a variety of rhythms which fit in that division of three. It could be a dotted quarter note, and those last for the length of 3/8 notes. It could be 3/8 notes. It could be an eighth rest and another eighth. It could be 6/16. So the rhythms simply need to align to the underlying division of three in the compound meter pulse. What is duple meter? What is triple meter? Yet another detail to know about meter is the difference between duple meter and triple meter. So now this is where students start to get a little bit confused. We just discussed the idea of simple meter, where the pulses are divided into twos, and compound meter, where the pulses are divided into threes. So what is this duple meter and triple meter thing? Are they the same? No, they're a totally separate idea. So the previous concepts of simple and compound describe what happens inside each strong pulse. Duple meter and triple meter describe the number of strong pulses in each measure. Let's look again at our examples of 3-4 and 6-8. So 3-4 time has three strong accents or strong beats. So 3-4 time is triple meter. Now, since each strong pulse in 3-4 gets divided into twos, we can describe 3-4 time completely by calling it triple simple meter. So three strong pulses, triple, divided into twos, simple, triple simple meter. 6-8 time has two strong beats. 6-8 is duple meter, And remember we said 6/8 is compound, so its two strong pulses are divided into threes. So 6/8 is duple compound meter. Two pulses, duple, divided into threes, compound. Okay, pop quiz. What would 9/8 time be? 9/8 is most commonly played with three strong beats. So 9/8 would be triple compound meter, three groups of 3/8 notes. And then what about 12/8? So it's most commonly played with four strong beats, which are divided into 3/8 note groupings. It's a trick question. There's also something called quadruple meter. And quadruple meter just describes four strong beats in a measure. Much of the music theory we learn evolved to explain European classical music. The duple, triple, quadruple distinction covered most of that music's time signatures and meters. Since then, music has gone on to explore many more meters, and you'll run into descriptions of quintuple, sextuple, or septuple meters. It's all about the number of strong pulses per measure. As a player and not a composer, does any of this really matter? Well, the essential part for you as a player is to understand that some meters have a triplet feel to the pulses, compound, and others don't, simple. When you understand that bit, the rest will make sense and fall into place. To properly play each meter, it's important for you to tune into where the strong and weak beats are. Now, will anyone ever say, quick, change to triple compound meter? No, it's very unlikely. Instead, they would just simply say 9/8. So knowing the terms is not as important as knowing the concept of where the accents fall and the patterns of strong and weak beats in each meter. Are there any meters that can't be described as simple or compound? Yes. So some meters are irregular or odd. For example, 5/8 can't be broken into consistent twos or threes. It won't add up. It has to be a 2 and a 3 or a 3 and a 2. So we would call 5/8 an irregular or odd meter. People sometimes split hairs over whether or not odd meter simply means that the top number is odd. Well, 3/4 time is considered simple. It's not irregular or odd. Even though it has a 3, an odd 3 number for the top number, it's still simple meter. In the next lessons, we'll be discussing different meters and time signatures more specifically.